In 2014 through 2017, 56,755 Americans were killed by guns. Out of that number, 1,333 of them were children under the age of 12. In 2017 alone, 15,590 Americans were killed by guns. These numbers give me a wide range of emotions. We are growing up in a generation that has seen more mass shootings than ever recorded. Today, I'll be talking about a rather tough subject, school shootings, but more specifically, the safety of teachers and students, the social media and the influences they have, and then the communities that are affected and how they handle the situation. First, I will be talking about the safety of teachers and students in the classrooms. The Department of Justice encourages school districts, and police departments in the communities to put police officers in the schools, as you can see in the second picture. This can build relationships in the schools and can increase security and create an overall safer environment. In 1990, metal detectors, as seen in this first picture, were added to schools in New York City that had a higher violence rate. This higher violence rate may be caused because of gangs, violence at home, or violence amongst themselves. Rutgers University researcher Richard Stansfield reported about 7% of teachers were threatened with violence in a given year. It is important for teachers and resources around the school to know what's going on with their students at all times. This is timing plays an important role in these violent events because large crowds, such as passing periods or lunch, can be more important to people planning these horrific events. Social media seems almost avoidable in today's society, and here are some ways it plays a role in such tragic events. It seems news stations jump at the chance to cover a breaking story, but this leaves journalists in a sticky situation. They are caught between needing to gather all the details on the shooter, the victims, anything that is involved, while also trying to be respectful to the families, the victims, and the communities that are affected. Most of the times, news stations and social media can undermine the effects of what is actually happening. But these news stations examine the situation in three different ways. They look at the characteristics of the shooter, maybe if they were isolated or bullied, many different reasons, the cause and the effect of the shooting, and then the communities and whether it played a role in the student. Next, I'll be talking about the communities that are affected. There are many different factors that go into shaping a student and how they interact with their peers. Factors such as socioeconomic status and their involvement in their community. These can play a big role because if the student feels isolated or singled out or that they don't have anybody they can talk to, it can cause them to seek attention. When they seek this attention, it can cause them to act out and go into the extreme as planning a school shooting. If students have the fear of violence, it can affect them going to school. They won't want to go to school, they won't do their homework, get their grades, and then it's just a snowball effect from there. It's important for teachers to promote positive learning environments for the students and create the safe environments. That way they'll want to come to school and they'll have a safe place they can go to. Lastly, I will be talking about the communities and how they handle and recover from these tragic events. Oftentimes, in hard situations, such as school shootings, communities come together. Counselors and other helping resources are put into schools in order for students to have somebody to talk to. But people in the communities play a bigger role than they would ever think. They have the power to put routines back in place and make things go back to normal, as stated by researcher Dr. Jolynn Carney. The people in the communities can create safe environments, end the rumors that are being spread, maintain routines, look for warning signs among the victims, and reassure them that they are not alone. But most importantly, they can allow the victims to grieve and mourn at their own pace. That way, if they rush back into things, they can feel overwhelmed, and then it can just cause another spiral effect. In conclusion, we hear nearly every month of a school shooting. I don't know if you guys heard, but on Tuesday, I read in the news about a school shooting. But safety is always a top priority, the safety of teachers and students. Social media will always play a role because of the society we are growing up in. We have news at our fingertips. and communities will play a large role in helping them come together and move on from the situation. But we are the generation that is growing up and will be in control of the society in a few short years, and we have the power to stop these events from happening.